Hey to you. I want to welcome you to another episode of How I Animate Clip Studio Paint. Okay, in today's episode, I'm just going to show you guys how I go about making an animation template. Also, I'm taking next week off so I can finish up an animation that I was working on. Also, I need to get in some more drawing practices. If you haven't been practicing your drawing, you need to get into it.
Also,
go ahead and hit that subscribe button and let's get straight into this episode. Okay, as you can see here, I have a video of an animation, just a walking scene that I took from the internet, from another anime, and I just brought it into Clip Studio Paint. If you don't know how to do that, I'm gonna show you real quick. You go to File, and then you go to Import, and then you go to Movie. You click on Movie, it'll open up your browser like anything else, and you click on the video clip that you would like, and it will bring it into Clip Studio Paint. Now, I pre-cut this one, so it only shows the walking scene, and let me show you it real quick. Really nice walking scene. And as you see, Clip Studio kind of processes videos really slowly. It's, you know, frame by frame. So what I did was I came in here and I just brought it down, brought the opacity down, and then I started to draw the shapes that I see. And that's basically what you're doing. You're drawing the shapes that you can see, And then later on, as you finish up the template, you can use the template for anything. And let me show you exactly what it came out to look like. So I'm not drawing the details of the jacket that much. I'm not drawing the details of the shoes that much or the pants, but I'm getting that nice outline. So as you can see, me doing it in the speed paint part where you show me sketching everything out really nice and really quickly, I'm not worried about the face. I'm not worried about any of that. I'm just worried about the shapes. Once you get the shapes, you don't have to worry about is it a girl, is it a guy. None of that matters, because once you start to sketch over your template, you can turn it into whatever you want. I could even shorten the arms. I can do all of that stuff. You can shorten the legs. All you're trying to do is make sure you get a feel for the flow of the walk. Now, as I finish up the template, you'll see that I'll go ahead and go back in and do a character over the template. And you'll see, this is a female. But when I go do a character over the template, I turn it into a male. And that's just how easy it is. Now, I can also make it into a female and do similar things, maybe have a different jacket, so on and so forth. But I want you to understand that just because you are taking from a reference doesn't mean that when you do your final character, it has to look like the reference. It's more about the flow of the walk, the swing of the hands. And if you can do it on a regular person, that's great. But just starting off doing it on animations that's already been created, it kind of helps you find shortcuts that you didn't know was there, which are hard to find out if you're not doing the work, using a bunch of references, going to places where professionals are already releasing their work. So I just thought this video would help you guys understand what I mean when I say using a template for your animation. I think that seeing it visually will help you understand it a little bit more. I think my last video, I went into it in a pretty detailed way, but seeing it is believing it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As you can see, this is the male character that I came out with, and you can see the walk, and it comes out pretty smooth. So I hope you guys got something from this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If not, hit the thumbs down button. If you loved it, share it with a friend. And I think that's it for this video. And as always, anime life forever.
I'm Taylor.